to see you children and you all are welcome to our English class of class 9 and today we shall see from the movement section and there is chapter 2 the adventures of Toto written by Ruskin Bond. So children, before we enter into the text, so let us learn a little bit what about the introductions to the lessons. So this is a humorous and adventurous stories of a naughty monkey named Toto. The writer's grandfather brought the monkey from a Tonga driver. The pranks played by Toto have been narrated an interesting way and make the story a must read for us. So children, let's enter into the text. Grandfather brought Toto from a Tonga driver for the sum of 5 rupees. The Tonga driver used to keep the little red monkey tied to a feeding trough, and the monkey looked so out of place there that grandfather decided he would add the little fellow to his private zoo. So dear children, here feeding trough means a large container for feeding animals and Tonga, that is horse craft. So the writer's grandfather purchased a monkey named Toto from a Tonga driver, okay, by paying 5 rupees to him. The Tonga driver had tied the little red colored monkey to a feeding trough, so that he could not run away. When the writer's grandfather saw the monkey, he had a desire to add him to the collections of animals which he had in his zoo at home. Toto was a pretty monkey. His bright eyes sparkled with mischief beneath deep set eyebrows, and his teeth, which were a pearly white, were very often displayed in a smile that frightened the life out of elderly Anglo-Indian ladies. But his hands looked dried up as though they had been pickled in the sun for many years. Yet his fingers were quick and wicked, and his tail, while adding to his good looks, grandfather believed a tail would add to anyone's good looks, also serve as a third hand. He could use it to hang from a branch, and it was capable of scooping off any delicacy that might be out of reach of his hands. So dear children, Anglo-Indian means a person relating to both Britain and India. Pickle means what? Food that is preserved in vinegar. Scooping off, that means lifting. The writer gives a description of Toto here in this passage. He had bright, shiny eyes, which were full of mischief. The eyebrows were deeply set on his face. His teeth were like pearls. Many ladies belonging to the Anglo-Indian community got scared when they saw his teeth, which were displayed when he smiled. Toto's hands were dry and wrinkled as if they had been dried in the sun like pickled vegetables. He had a long tail. The writer's grandfathers thought that the tail attached to the good looks on an animal. Toto's tail was like a third hand for him. It helped him hang from the branch of a tree. He also uses to lift objects which were behind his hand's reach. Grandmother always first when grandfather brought home some new bird or animals. So it was decided that Toto's presence should be kept a secret from her until she was in a particularly good mood. Grandfather and I put him away in a little closet opening into my bedroom wall, where he was tied securely, or so we thought, to peg fastened into the wall. So see, children, time. The writer's grandmother was against the grandfather's attitudes of bringing new pets, birds and animals. So the grandfather thought that they would conceal this fact from her until she was in a good mood. At the time, they would disclose this to her. The writer and his grandmother secured Toto into a little cupboard in the writer's room in order to be sure that Toto did not escape. They tied him to a hook in the wall. A few hours later, when grandfather and I came back to release Toto, we found that the walls which had been covered with some ornamental papers chosen by a grandfather now stood out as naked brick and plaster. The peg in the wall had been wrenched from its socket, and my school blazer, which had been hanging there, was in shreds. I wondered what grandmother would say. But grandfather didn't worry. He seems pleased with Toto's performance. So children, ornamental means here, decorative will be there, okay? And naked means what? Uncovered. And wrenched means broke. And socket means attachment. And you see, shred means what? Cut into thin slices. Okay? So the writers and his grandfathers went to Toto after a few hours, and the sight was shocking. Toto had torn the decorative wallpaper. He had broken the hook and escaped from his binding. Also, he tore the writer's pleasures into pieces. "He is clever," said grandfather. "Given time, I am sure he could have tied the torn pieces of your blazers into a rope and made his escape from the window." The grandfather was quite delighted to see Toto's adventure. He felt that Toto was very clever. He said that if they would have given him more time, he would have tied the thin pieces of the writer's torn blazer into a rope and would have escaped out of the window. His presence in the house still a secret. Toto was now transformed into a big cage in servants' quarters, where a number of grandmother's pet lived very sociably together. A tortoise, a pair of rabbits, a tame squirrel, and for a while, my pet goat. But the monkey or don't allow any of his companions to sleep at night. So grandfather, who had to leave Dehradun next day to collect his pension in Saranpur, decided to take him along. Okay, then what happened? You see, children, sociably, that means what? In a friendly manner. So Toto was shifted to the servant's quarter. He was put in a case. He would live others with the other pets in grandfather's zoo. This zoo comprised of a tortoise, a pair of rabbits, squirrels, and that is what writer's pet goat. Toto was very mischievous. He did not let animals sleep at night. The writer's grandfather had to leave for Saranpur the next day. He decided to take Toto along as he was unmanageable because he was mischievous. Unfortunately, I could not accompany grandfather on the trip, but he told me about it afterwards. A big black canvas kit bag was provided for Toto. This, with some straw at the bottom, became his new abode. When the bag was closed, there was no escape. Toto could not get his hands through the opening, and the canvas was too strong for him to bite his way through. His efforts to get out only had the effect of making the bag roll about on the floor or occasionally jump into the air. An exhibition that attracted a crowd of onlookers on the Dehradun railway platform. So children, abode means here home. So the writer was disappointed as he could not accompany his grandfather and Toto on the trip. His grandfather narrated the happenings of the trip to him later. So he had a special bag for Toto. It was made of a strong material, canvas. He placed some dry grass at the bottom of the bag. On the trip, the bag would be Toto's home as he would live in it. The bag had a zipper on top of it. The writer's grandfather ensured that when the bag was closed, Toto would not be able to escape out of it. Neither could he come out of the opening as it was closer with a zipper, nor could it bite the strong canvas material in order to run away. Still, Toto made unsuccessful attempts to come out of the bag. Due to this, many times the bag would roll on the floor or it would suddenly jump in the air. These moments were noticed by the people of the railway platform and made them curious to know what was inside the bag. Toto remained in the bag as far as Saranpur. But while grandfather was producing his ticket at the railway, turnstile, okay, Toto suddenly poked his head out of the bag and gave the tickets collector a whiz grin. So children, turnstile, a mechanical gate consisting of revolving horizontal arms fixed to vertical post, allowing only one person at a time to pass through. Then what happened, you see? Toto remained secure in grandfather's bag till Saranpur. So then what happened, you see, at the Saranpur railway station, the writer's grandfather was taking out his tickets to cross the turnstile. Okay, so at the time, Toto picked out of the bag and smiled at the ticket collector.